Hi, Koshi. My name is Christina Zeng, and I am the founder and owner of Zen Ramen. Our product is a low-carb vegan noodle made from a Japanese yam, and it also happens to be gluten-free and dry-packed. I started the business as a bit of a side hustle and a passion project, and we recently launched our website. I'm seeing good traffic come through and a lot of customers buying our products. However, my question is, I'm finding that some sales are being lost at checkout once customers are seeing the shipping costs being added to the final price. How can I prevent this from happening in the future? Thanks, Koshi.
Thanks, Christina. It sounds like a great product. I love noodles, and I love that such a great product has gone from being a side hustle to a more serious business for you. Well done. Now, the issue you're facing is what's called shopping cart abandonment, and it's really common with online shopping. Research shows that consumers tend to abandon their cart if they're presented with an unexpected cost, if they were only browsing and not actually ready to make the purchase just yet, or if the overall price is too expensive. In your case, it's your shipping costs that's putting customers off, and it's not surprising. Now, I looked at your site and saw that buying a single pack of noodles to try costs $7.95, and the shipping cost is the same. But to buy your five-pack, it's $39.95 with free shipping. Obviously, buying a single pack is a turn-off because the price doubles when the shipping cost is added. Why not just sell the five-pack or promote it as a get one pack free to try, and if you don't like it, send the other four back and we'll refund your money? It's basically a try before you buy model, but you're banking on the fact that your noodles are so great, no one will return them, or they're gonna be too lazy to return them. You could also try sending an email immediately after a shopper abandons you, asking them if they would like to take advantage of your free shipping offer. You've only got a couple of hours to get them back, so why not try upselling them to the five pack at the same time? Another way to solve this problem is to not give your customers any additional costs. Be upfront about the shipping costs. Don't surprise them when they get to the checkout, like I was really surprised. Or if you don't want to market the overall price, build in a calculator which clearly displays the shipping costs from the beginning of the purchase journey, not just at the end. You could also try adding a save for later button, which allows shoppers to create a wish list of products they want to buy that can easily be turned into a sale later. You'll need to send a reminder or follow-up email to get them to finish the purchase though, but don't push the sale. Let them be the one in the control seat. Now, I hope that helps, Christina. It's a really common problem. Make sure you email us at kbb@pinstripemedia.com.au to let us know how you go. Or if anyone else wants to send in a question, that's the email address.